Approximately 66.06 million years ago, a highly destructive event which would change the Indian subcontinent forever was ongoing. Whereas, if we were to go back in time and look at the landscape as it existed on that year, we would see a valley with adjacent mountains. However, only 50,000 years later, all of this would vanish, being completely buried underneath as much as 2,000 meters thick of lava. What caused such large volumes of lava to erupt was an incredibly rare type of volcanic eruption sequence referred to as a flood basalt. These flood basalt eruptions eventually output a total of 1.2 million cubic kilometers of lava in a 760,000-year-long time span, devastating the Earth's ecosystems by causing repeated extreme episodes of global cooling followed by global warming, along with ocean acidification. This massive outpouring of rock occurred in India and is today referred to as the Deccan Traps, which covered an area of 1.5 million square kilometers, or an area approximately 82% the size of the nation of Indonesia. These traps measure up to 3,400 meters or 11,154 feet thick. As a whole, flood basalts are fairly rare in Earth's geologic history, with only 16 flood basalt provinces known to have erupted during the last 400 million years. Adding to this, the last flood basalt province, the Columbia River basalts, has been completely extinct since 6 million years ago. While flood basalts are speculated to be able to form due to a number of reasons, we are 100% certain what created the Deccan Traps. Specifically, a massive superplume hotspot in the mantle which represented the very beginnings of the modern-day Reunion hotspot. When large-scale hotspots form, they rise through the mantle because of their high temperature, which makes them less dense. Continuing to rise through the mantle, the broad mushroom-shaped head of the mantle plume will eventually reach the crust. When this occurs, large volumes of magma are injected into the crust across a wide area. This subsequently triggers highly voluminous eruptions on the surface, forming a flood basalt. From these fissures, which can be as much as 250 kilometers in length, magma erupts at a high rate, filling low points and completely coating the landscape in a layer of black basaltic lava. Eventually, all of the molten rock in the head of the mantle plume disappears, having largely been erupted, and all that is left is a simple hotspot, causing the flood basalt to cease erupting. The first eruption of the Deccan Traps occurred 66.3 million years ago, a full 257,000 years before the Chicxulub impact crater formed. At the time, the Indian subcontinent wasn't located within Asia, but instead off the eastern coast of Madagascar, near where the modern St. Brandon Islands are located. As lava erupted onto the surface from a several-mile-long fissure, fountains of lava were generated which carried molten rock several hundred feet into the air. But, as the eruption continued, the fissure kept expanding in both directions, soon surpassing 100 miles in length. The entire length of the fissure was erupting instead of one vent, outputting 3,000 cubic meters of lava per second. To understand how extensive this would have been, this is equivalent to 695 simultaneous eruptions of the Kilauea volcano in Hawaii. Over a period of 5 years, this eruption continued, flooding a large swath of India's Gujarat and molten rock across an area of more than 5,000 square kilometers. By the time this individual eruption had ended, this area had been covered in an average of 300 feet thick of lava. Individual lava flows from the single eruption traveled up to 150 miles distant from its source vent, marking a truly impressive eruption. In total, 473 cubic kilometers of molten rock was emplaced on the surface in this short time span. Eruptions like the one just described repeated an average of once every 473 years for the next 200,000 years, emplacing 200,000 cubic kilometers of lava. More vents eventually formed in other states, and although activity would wane, it would peak once again for a 50,000-year spurt where an approximately 500 cubic kilometer eruption would occur every 50 years. The Deccan Traps would then go on to wane in intensity, although two additional upticks in activity occurred 65.92 to 65.82 million years ago and 65.65 to 65.6 million years ago. In total, approximately 2,500 eruptions occurred, creating numerous stepping stone-like plateaus. These basalts would go on to host some of the world's best zeolite mineral deposits, which largely formed when cooling lava with cavities in them interacted with groundwater. As a final note, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.